How's it going, everybody? This is Ash, and a warm welcome to another Let's Play of Train Simulator with the Canadian theme. And this is the second Let's Play with the SD60, that is the EMD SD60 Canadian Pacific livery, on the Canadian remote passes. And this is daytime, folks, so this one should be a bit easier to do than that switching scenario that was at night time. So we are in winter, and we'll just pan the camera around, just having a wee look at this. This is the train we're going to be using, so got a nice daytime view of it, so we can see it better than we could in the last scenario that covered this train. So without further ado, let's get started and let's see what the task is all about. There are some nice features on this train as well, so you can actually open the cab door, so that's very nice. Just panning around, just having a look at the controls and stuff before we get started, folks. As you know, I don't have scoring mode turned on, so I just use career mode as if it was just a normal standard scenario. So I'm just going to reset the camera position and we're all set to go. Okay, I think I'm supposed to reverse onto that freight train that was just at the back on the other line. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to use the 8 camera just to get to the switch, and then I will reverse onto that and pick it up. Thank you. just had a look on the work order on the mini map there, the 2D map, and it is this train we will have to attach ourselves to the front of. So I'm just going to be careful with the brakes here, folks. I don't want to go too fast, and the brakes are not very responsive as I'm going downhill, so I will have to be careful not to go too fast into the freight train, so I don't want to fail the mission. So I'm just going to use some braking, a bit of heavy braking, just to keep our speed under control here, folks. Okay, so just got to be careful of that. So once we've attached ourselves to this GE ES44 AC, we should be very much ready to go, and try and bring that down to about 3 miles an hour. Have to wait for the brakes to kick in. So there we are, we're nearly there, folks. So that's very much our train all attached, and just going to do full service braking, put it into emergency, as for whatever reason the brakes are quite sluggish on this train. And once I put the reverser into forwards, the ditch lights will come on. And what I'm going to do, folks, whilst we are in this position, I'm just going to return to the cab, well, reset the front camera first, then jump in the cab, quickly do a thumbnail image, and then we can get stuck in with getting this scenario all done. Okay, without further ado, let's get the power onto the traction motors then, and let's head towards our destination. We have to make sure we've got enough power, because we are going to be starting off going uphill. But we have got 2 SD60s on the front, so no bother there. And it's just a matter of getting the train going. So I'm just going to use notch 3 just to move this heavy train up the hill. We should be more than enough to get us going anyways. As the key point here is, folks, definitely not to put too much force on the couplers, otherwise they can break and we don't want that. Have to assume that this is an insulated cab as well, as when I blow the horn you can't really hear it very much inside the cab, although in external view I assume you can, but in the cab you can't. And just turned on the, well, trying to use the I key to turn on the display. What we'll do, we'll have a look at some switches once we get clear of this tunnel, as I do like to have the gauge lights turned on so I can see what I'm doing when going through tunnels and stuff. that, my friends, is a very nice sight. Just for the record, in terms of the cab lights and gauge lights and stuff, although the I key does nothing on this add-on, the L key is the one that turns on and off the cab lights, so I'll just use that to turn on the gauge lights quicker rather than waiting to come out of the tunnel. But very nice signs, but they don't seem to play at a constant fixed volume. As you heard there, it just revs up and then it goes all quiet again. We do have a caution signal here, folks, so we should be grand when we get clear of this passover. Well, I'm just going to check the tab, but there is no response, no permission denied, so we're grand and we can continue to go. Have you noticed something about the signs on this train, folks? It's very bad. The horn is very badly looped, as to be honest, it's not looping like it should be. As I did the sequence there of two longs, then a short and a long, but when I was doing that, it's like with some of the other trains, it's got like a ping to it, as if it's not been looped properly. So, folks, any of you that are watching this video, do you know of any good replacement horn sounds or replacement enhancement or an SD60 enhancement pack or something that's available for this? Because I would like better sounds, as the sounds on this are not that great, I have to say. As the looping of the horn especially, it's not that great. So if you go to notch 4, it suddenly goes louder, and when you ease off, it goes real quiet again. Then basically when you power down, when you notch down, there's not that instant cutoff. It kind of plays a segment, then it actually goes louder, then it goes all nice and quiet again. So if there are any replacement sounds for this, or some sound mods just to make the sounds work better, please let me know in the comment section below, as I will use them. And I do have a Canadian National version of this train as well, but I don't have any routes or anything like that to use it on yet. Although I will get the route in another steam cell, as I'm looking to do Canadian routes as well as American ones, as this is kind of my favourite trains and that, you know. But in all honesty, the sounds on this add-on, it's not that great. And sadly, the cab doesn't have any opening windows, although the cab doors do work, which is nice, but sadly, no opening cab windows. Anyway, folks, what's your opinion on this add-on? The 3D model is great, and the cab is okay, but sounds, bit of a letdown, especially on the looping part. But anyway, folks, back on topic and staying with this let's play, we're just entering a 30 miles an hour zone, so soon enough we can open the power up again once the back of our train clears the speed board. Okay, folks, I'm not sure if that will be the end of this Let's Play. I don't know, but this is where we will be required to stop the train at Lake Louise North Track, which is just under 5 miles to go. So that could be the end of where this scenario will finish. I don't know, but I will advise further when I get nearer to it. Anyways, better use a wee bit of braking here, folks, as we do not want to break the speed limit. I'm just going to wait for the brakes to kick in as well, as there is a bit of a delay. Thank you. Folks, we're just about a mile or less to go before we reach Lake Louise North Track. I'm not sure if it'll be a double loop. I'm not even sure how far we're off the next signal, which is a danger. So I'm just going to close that refusal notice. So we cannot pass the signal. So I'm assuming it will be, it is located after the checkpoint for this train. So I'm assuming that would be near enough the end of this scenario, I'm assuming. But I do hope you are enjoying this one, folks. Even though this add-on may be buggy in terms of the sounds, but all in all, I do like the 3D modelling, as it has got a nice cab and the train itself does work okay. Nice to see a trio of SD60s in the middle of that consist on that NPC train to our right. So I'm just going to ease off the power here as our signal is not clear. So I don't want to miss our checkpoint either. But I did slow down a wee bit too much. So I just don't want to miss the end point for this, as I do have a feeling that this scenario will be finishing off, will finish once we reach the signal checkpoint, as there is just a checkpoint that I need to get the locomotive on, and that will be the end of this scenario, I'm assuming. And I think it is, because the signal has not changed. So I'm just going to dump the brakes, and I just want to say to you a big thank you for watching. If you watched all the way through, till next time, folks, take care of yourselves and each other. All the best, God bless, and I'll catch you in the next one. All done for now, folks. I'll see you in the next Let's Play.